Hello my dear students, welcome back to Learn Physics. In today's topic, we are going to discuss about the rest of the portions in semiconductor electronics. So the topic covering today is optoelectronic devices. What is this optoelectronic devices? They are the devices in which charge carriers are produced due to the effect of photons or light. Optoelectronic means the effect of light, right? So here we are going to study about some of the devices where we use light or production of light or using light for the production of current. The same way we are using over here, that is optoelectronic devices. First one which we are learning is optoelectronic device. In optoelectronic devices, first one, photodiode is working under reverse bias. Okay, it's a PN junction diode which is working under reverse bias. So here I am considering a PN junction. So you know, in P region majority carriers are the holes, and N region electrons are the majority carriers. But at the PN junction, what will happen? Electrons will be ionized, negative charge ions will be here. Negative ions will be here at the P region, and positive ions will be here at this N region. Due to the presence of positive ions in N region, a depletion layer will be generating. Here it is negative and here it is positive. Okay, so this is an electric field will be generating over here. If we are connecting it in a reverse bias, what will happen? Yes, the charge carriers or the depletion layer also will be increasing. Okay, because it is in the same direction, so it will be added up. So potential will be, or barrier potential will be increasing. Now, how the photodiodes are working? Here photodiodes are fabricated with a glass window at the junction. So what will happen when light ray is incidenting at the PN, at the junction or potential barrier, at the potential barrier, when light rays are incidenting, if it has enough energy than the energy gap, what will happen? These electrons, electrons will be accepting the photons and will be electron or holes will be generating over there. Okay, suppose an electron is generating over here and the same time hole also will be creating. So there is a chance for recombining electron and hole. So when light ray is incidenting at the PN junction or near to the junction, so here in photodiode, it is arranged in such a way to incident the light at the junction or near to the junction. When light ray is incidenting, if it is having enough amount of energy inside that, it will remove the electron from its position. Electrons will be getting excited and it will come out from the actual position. So when electron is coming outside, out from the position, a hole also will be generating. Right, so if an electron hole pair is forming, so there is a chance for recombination also, but due to the effect of this reverse biasing, electron will be moving to the N side and holes will be moving to the P side. Okay, because of the effect of this reverse bias, what will happen? Electron will be moving to the N side and holes will be moving towards the, so it won't be recombining. Without recombining, it will be moving out, okay, to their respective positions. So here this photodiodes will be working under the effect of reverse bias. Why is it so? We know, see, if I am considering N type semiconductor, electrons are the majority carriers over there. Okay, electrons are N is the majority carriers and P is the minority carriers. So number of electrons will be more than the number of holes. right? So if electron holes are recombining, a delta N is producing. This is the extra amount of electrons which is produced due to the effect of photons. And here delta P, this will be equal in number. But when we are taking the fraction, so N plus delta N, when I am considering, N plus delta N will be greater than P plus delta P, because this is the majority carriers. But when we are considering the fraction of this electrons, N divided by delta N, or P divided by, sorry, the fraction of electrons created only we are considering. So delta N divided by N and delta P divided by P, when we are considering, which will be greater? Yes, delta P by P will be greater, which is because P value is less, right? So delta P by P will be more. Delta P by P, when we are considering, this will be more than this. So it is easy to identify the outflow of current if we are using the reverse bias. So here electrons, because of the flow of electrons and holes to the respective position, what will happen? So electrons are moving out through the outside output terminal. See, through this terminals, what will electrons and holes will be moving out? So if we are using a resistor or external device over here, it will be current will be flowing through the circuit, and that can be identified through this device. So if light is falling on it, it will be giving out current. So that is the photodiode. Okay, so if more amount of current is flowing through that, then it will be difficult for us to identify. That is why we are using reverse bias over in photodiodes. In photodiodes, we are using reverse bias because of this condition, because N is very much greater, right? N is very much greater than P. So since delta N, fractional change in electron or fractional change in hole pair, when we are considering, delta P by P is much greater than delta N by N. That is why we are using reverse bias. Okay, clear children? So this is about the photodiodes. So next optoelectronic device which we are using, which we are considering, as this light emitting diode. Now that light emitting diode also, we are using a PN junction diode only, but light will be emitting with the help of, if we are using a forward bias in this LEDs. So in LED, PN junction is working under forward bias. So next optoelectronic device which we are considering is light emitting diode. So this LEDs are working under forward bias. Okay, if a PN junction is connected under forward bias, LED light will be emitting, or photons will be generating. How this LEDs are working? So I am considering a PN junction diode. In this, holes are the majority carriers at the P side, and N side electrons are the majority carriers. As I said previously, here a negative charge will be creating and a positive charge will be creating due to the presence of potential barrier. If I am considering, if we are connecting that to the forward bias, P to the positive and N to the negative, what will happen? See, here it is positive and here it is negative. So barrier potential will be reducing. So here electrons, holes will be coming over here. Positive charge will be coming to this side, and it will be recombining with the negative ions. When this recombination happens, some amount of energy will be released. That energy will be coming out as photons. So light energy will be creating over there, or generating over there. That is the working of LED. Okay, so here positive charge is there. Positive charge, so V minus V0. This is the barrier potential. It will be reducing. Barrier potential will be reducing. So holes will be, the positive charge will be moving towards the negative charge. What will happen? When they are recombining, photons will be generating, or light will be emitting over there. So that is the working of LED. That is how LED is working. LED, we know it is under different colors it is. So now we know LEDs are available in different colors. And for the LED to work, a minimum band gap of 1.8 electron volt is required. for the LED to work properly, it should have a minimum energy gap of 1.8 electron volt. If we are considering the characteristic curve of LED, it is the same like in forward bias characteristic, how we learned the same characteristic curve, only we will be getting for LED also. But in the case of photodiode we didn't discuss, right? Photodiode, how the VI characteristic curve will be, see here, this is I and this is V. We know it was working under reverse bias, right? So in reverse bias, so here working will be like this. This is how we will be representing the forward. This is I1, I2, I3. I1 greater than, I3 greater than, I2 greater than I1. I1 is the least one, so here in microamps. This is how photodiode, the characteristic curve, but the characteristic curve of LED will be like this. The same like the forward bias characteristic of PN junction diode. Now we are going to see we know the LEDs are available in different colors. How we will be getting this? Some compound or gallium arsenide phosphide, like that compounds, when we are getting, we will be getting different colors also. And now we will look into the different colors, how we will be getting and what are the advantages of this optoelectronic device, that is LED, through slides we will see. Okay. So here we are going to study about LED. In LED, the semiconductor must have at least 1.8 electron volt band gap, and the compound semiconductor gallium arsenide phosphide, that is one semiconductor, it's a mixture of everything, is used for making LEDs of different colors. Different color we will be obtaining from this compound semiconductor. What are the uses of LED? The first one is, we are using that in remote controls and in burglar alarms and optical communications. These are the uses of LEDs. And next we are going to study about the advantages of LED. What are the advantages? It has low operational voltage. Low voltage only is required, that is less power. It will be having less power. So consumption of current also will be very less over there. It's a fast action and no warmer. That means warm up time is not required. When we are switching on, that time itself it will glow. Next is, it is almost monochromatic. Same wavelength is of order of band gap between 100 angstrom to 500 angstrom. So it's almost monochromatic light, and it is having long life and ruggedness. Ruggedness is strength wise also, it's very strong also, and fast on off switching capability. These are the advantages of LED. So next we are going to study about solar cells. What are these solar cells? Solar cells are working under almost the same principle like photodiodes. In photodiodes, how current is producing when light energy is falling, incidenting on the surface, electron hole pairs are generating and those pairs are giving out current, right? So same phenomenon only, but here no external biasing is required. No external biasing in the case of solar cells. So we will be having a p-type semiconductor over here, and on p-type semiconductor we will be keeping diffusing an n-type semiconductor. Now it became a p-n junction diode, right? So here, when light energy of incident is falling on the surface of n-type, electrons will be generating. Electron hole pair is not only electron, when electrons are coming out, what will happen? These holes also will be generating. Electron hole pair is generating. Okay, and after the production of this electron hole pair, electron will be moving towards the N region and holes will be moving towards the P region. Right, so electron will be moving towards the hole, its N region, and holes will be moving towards the, so recombination won't be happening over there because of the junction barrier or barrier potential. It will be moving, electrons will be moving towards the N type, N region, and holes will be moving towards the P region. So we will be getting a negative terminal over here, since the amount of negative charge is more over here, a negative terminal at this point and a positive terminal at this point. If we are using an output resistance, we will be getting a current through the through the load resistance. See here, I am getting a load resistance, and we can find out the we can see current is passing through the load resistance. Okay, clear? So this is how a solar cell is working. So if working a solar cell, if we are see here, we are not taking any current from for the solar cell. We are not taking any current, right? So that is why VI characteristic of a solar cell will be in the fourth quadrant. This is for the short circuit, and this is open circuit potential at the open circuit. Okay, it is given at the fourth quadrant since we are not drawing any current to the from the circuit. Okay, see, for the circuit we are not using any current, right? And but it is giving out electric current. So this is how solar cells are working. Okay, clear children? So now we will look into the some of the advantages of this solar cells. And okay, so in which and all materials will be required, that and all we are going to study about this solar cell. So here we are going to look into the solar cell, what and all we studied now. See, these are the steps for the production of electricity from solar cell. For that, first step is when light is incidenting on the cell, electron hole pair is generating. Second one, separation of electron and hole due to the electric field of depletion region. Due to the presence of electric field, the electron and hole are separating at the time of production itself. Then third one, the electrons reaching N side are collected by the front contact, and holes reaching the P side are collected by the back contact. And one more thing that you should note down is, semiconductor with band gap close to 1.5 electron volt are ideal for the solar cell fabrication. And the next one, selection criteria for the material. So first one, band gap, we should consider, that is between 1.5 electron volt we told. Then also from 1 to 1.8 electron volt we will use. Okay. The next one, high optical absorption and electrical conductivity, availability of raw materials, cost. These and all we should consider while choosing a material for solar cell. Then what are the uses? Uses are power electronic devices in satellites, and as well as satellites and space stations also we are using the same thing, solar cell. Power supply to some of the calculators, digital watches and all, we will use this solar cell. Production of low cost photovoltaic cells also, we will use the this same solar cell only. These are the uses. So I think today's video is useful for you, and if you like the channel, please don't forget to subscribe, like and share. Thank you for watching. Bye.